a considerable amount of equipment associated with keeping bees, and that's even if you're a hobbyist beekeeper and certainly all the way up to a commercial beekeeper. So I want to talk a little bit about equipment management when that equipment is not deployed to the field. In other words, there will be times that your workshop looks a lot like what it looks behind me right now, just stacks of supers or lids or boxes, etc. So let me talk a little bit about proper handling of that when it's in storage. First of all, a lot of beekeeping equipment is made of wood. Not all of it, but a lot of it is. And so because of that, you don't want to leave it in direct sunlight where it can get rained on, etc., when it's not in use. This will absolutely set it up to rot. It will take that expensive box or frame, etc., that you purchased and render it nearly useless pretty quickly. Here at the University of Florida, we're very fortunate because we have an indoor space where we can store our beekeeping equipment. It happens to be climate controlled. That's certainly not necessary, but I do recommend that anytime beekeeping equipment is not in use, it be put in a shelter where it can not get direct sun or direct rain. At home, I keep my beekeeping equipment under a shed that just has two sides, and so the vast majority of the time it doesn't get direct sunlight and it never gets rain. I worry less with woodenware about cold or heat, but if you're storing things like foundation, that's very temperature sensitive. You don't want to store it in a space that's not climate controlled. If it's too hot, it can damage it. If it's too cold, it can make it brittle. So anytime you can keep things, again, out of direct sunlight, that's absolutely a plus. Another thing that you need to consider with equipment is extending its life. I've already alluded earlier to the fact that beekeeping equipment costs money, and that cost goes up and up and up seemingly every day, certainly every year. So you want to protect that expenditure that you made. So for example, with woodenware, you want to keep it painted. I recommend usually to paint beekeeping equipment every 3 to 5 years, depending on the environment in which you live. Here in Florida, it's quite harsh, so it might require every 3 years, but in other places around the world, it might be less harsh, and you can get away with painting every 5 years. When you bring equipment into storage, that's a great time to do that painting or refurbish it. A lot of beekeepers, when they bring in their boxes or their frames, etc., will scrape the propolis or any excess wax all off of those. That's generally an okay idea. Sometimes it may be considered unnecessary work. We tend to do it because we like to keep things nice and tidy. It's also a good time when you bring it in storage to fix any holes that might have developed in that woodenware. Of all the pieces of equipment in beekeeping, frames are one of those pieces that tend to take the most damage. And so when you bring it into storage, it's a great time to repair. Are there missing nails? Are the frame ends, those lugs on the tips of the top bar, broken? If you look in equipment catalogs, you can see that there's a lot of different pieces of things that you can purchase to repair frames, to refurbish frames, etc., to extend their life. Another piece of equipment that you have to be incredibly mindful of when you bring it into storage and think about appropriate storage is all of the wax that the bees produce. Why do I say this? Well, wax is actually a fairly stable thing that bees make. Think about it. They're keeping it in their hives. It's roughly about 94.5 degrees Fahrenheit or roughly 34 degrees Celsius. So that's a pretty warm temperature, and you get those fluctuations in the bees can thermoregulate their colony, so wax is pretty good under those temperatures. Outside of that temperature, outside of the protection of bees, wax can be incredibly vulnerable. In fact, you know as a beekeeper, there's this particular hive pest that we call wax moths. Wax moths are actually two different species of moths. There's a greater wax moth and a lesser wax moth. These moths develop on beeswax and the associated stuff, the old debris that's in the wax, bits of pollen, bits of that slight cocoon that bees spin while they're developing. So when you bring wax into storage, you have to be very mindful of wax moths. Any unprotected wax absolutely will get destroyed at some point. I've yet to put a frame somewhere on planet Earth that a wax moth didn't ultimately find. Here at the University of Florida, we're very fortunate because we have a very big walk-in freezer where we can keep all of the combs that we are not using. So that freezing temperature eliminates the risk that wax moths pose to our wax. But if I were storing wax here behind me on these shelves, the wax moths would come in. I've yet to find a store shed or a garage or a facility that is sealed tight enough to keep wax moths out. So once you bring combs into storage, if you're not freezing it, or maybe even refrigerating it, then you're going to have to protect it, likely using some of the chemical treatments that are available on the market. You can find those in many of your equipment supply catalogs. And wax is particularly valuable because bees use honey, they use sugar to make that wax. And so if wax moths destroy it and bees have to rebuild it someday, you've lost honey production or it'll cost you in feed. So follow these little tidbits of information to protect your woodenware, to protect your equipment associated with beekeeping, and most importantly, protect that wax that bees work so hard to build.